A very good morning, children. Today I am going to continue the same lesson, that is lesson 7 of science 2, that is energy flow in an ecosystem. In last lecture or previous lecture I have covered so many topics. Let us recall the main topic. First is the ecosystem, what we have studied. An ecosystem is a community of living organism in conjunction with the non-living components of their environment interacting as a system. This is called ecosystem. Let us see the next topic, that is food chain. Interaction go on continuously between producers, consumers and saprophytes. There is a definite sequence in these interaction which is called food chain. Third is food web. Each chain consists of 4 to 5 or more link. An ecosystem consists of many food chains that are interconnected at various level. Thus a food web is formed. Next is energy pyramid. An energy pyramid is a graphical representation showing the flow of energy at each trophic level in an ecosystem. Now we will see the different type of the biogeochemical cycle. Different type of the cycle. First is the biogeochemical cycle. Second is carbon cycle. Third is oxygen cycle. Fourth is nitrogen cycle. Let us see first biogeochemical cycle. As the term indicate, or if you notice the term biogeochemical, what is the meaning of it? It covers everything on the earth. Let me tell you, the bio suggests all the living organism on the earth. That means biotic component. Geo suggests on non-living part of the earth as land, water, air. That means abiotic component. And chemical suggests different reaction which occurs on earth. So we can understand what is biogeochemical cycle. Let us see the two main points. The cyclical flow of nutrient within an ecosystem is known as the biogeochemical cycle. It is the movement of chemical substances due to interaction of biotic and abiotic component of the earth. So let me highlight important point for you. Let us see here, children, the cyclical flow of nutrients within an ecosystem is called the biogeochemical cycle. So this way we can see that you can define this way biogeochemical cycle. Now let us see here some more point, that here we will see, children, that nutrients necessary for the growth of the organism are continuously transferred from biotic to abiotic factor within an ecosystem. It means it is a cyclical process. This cycle operates continuously through the medium of biosphere formed by the lithosphere, atmosphere and hydrosphere. So let us see here, this biosphere, let us highlight the point. It is this biosphere is formed by you can see this biosphere is formed by lithosphere, lithosphere and atmosphere and hydrosphere. So this way we can see that these are the important components of this. Now here we will see the recycling of biological, geological and chemical sources of nutrient in this process is a complex process and depend on the level of energy transferred in the ecosystem. Now there are two types of the biogeochemical cycle. First one is gaseous cycle and second one is the sedimentary cycle. So first let us see the gaseous cycle. I'll show you children this gaseous cycle. Let us highlight the point for you children. And accumulation of the main abiotic gaseous nutrient material is found in the Earth's atmosphere. It includes nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, water vapor, etc. Is it clear, children? So how you will define the gaseous cycle? An accumulation of the main abiotic gaseous nutrient material which are found in the Earth atmosphere. As example, you can see nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, water vapor, etc. Is it clear, I hope? Now come to the second one. See children, this is sedimentary cycle. Second one is sedimentary cycle. Let us highlight the point for you. And accumulation of the main abiotic nutrient material is found in soil, sediment and sedimentary rock, etc. on the earth. It includes soil component like iron, calcium, phosphorus, etc. So these are the main point which I have highlighted for you. So this is the difference between this both of them. Now let us see. Now the gaseous cycle is a speedier cycle than the sedimentation cycle. For example, if carbon dioxide has accumulation in an earth then or in an area, then it is quickly dispersed with the wind or it may be absorbed by the plant. Climatic change and human activities, they seriously affect the speed, intensity and equilibrium of these cycles. Therefore, various aspects of these cycles are extensively can be studied. Let us see now how next cycle is carbon cycle and how they are related. The cycle of gas and sedimentary cycle cannot be completely separated from each other. For example, nitrogen is present in the form of gas in the atmosphere and in the form of compound like nitrogen dioxide in the soil and sediment. Same way the carbon also occurs in the abiotic form. As you know, it is a abiotic component and it is present in the coal, granite, diamond, etc. in the earth crust and also in the form of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. Generally, carbon dioxide is present in the plants and animals for a much shorter duration than it is present in the coal. So now let us see the first, let us understand the composition of the gases in the atmosphere. So composition of air, if you'll see, we can see it is made up of many different gases, including oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, inert gases, etc. Carbon dioxide, nitrogen, oxygen, these are important factor and these are useful for the living being. The amount of these gases in the atmosphere is maintained by carbon cycle, oxygen cycle and nitrogen cycle. First, let us see the carbon cycle. Okay, children. So, I'll show here the figure of carbon cycle. This is the next figure, that is the carbon cycle what you have to study. Let us see the carbon cycle diagram. Here it is. So, we will see here that the carbon cycle maintains the amount of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere by taking carbon dioxide from the air and releasing carbon dioxide back to the atmosphere. Students, if you will see the diagram here, in that you can understand when green plants undergo the process of photosynthesis. Here you can see the green plant in the diagrams. Can you see, children? Green plants. Let us show you that these are the green plants which are present in the atmosphere. Now, these green plants undergo the process of photosynthesis and then they prepare food which is absorbing carbon dioxide from the air. The carbon dioxide element stored in plant is transferred to the animal. Now let us see, from here this is transferred to the animals. Now again we will see that when they eat plants, who eat plant? Animals. So when plants and animals die, their dead bodies decompose. So when the body decompose, then they are changed to fossil fuels. So when they change to fossil fuels, and this decomposition is done by the fungi and bacteria in the soil. So when they die, their body decompose. In addition, all the living organism including plant and animal release carbon dioxide. Then this carbon dioxide is further goes into the air through the process of respiration in their entire lifetime. Over a period of time, the bodies of the organism become fossil fuels which are used in the factories. Can you see here? In the factories they are used and carbon dioxide is going out from the factory. So as well as these fuels are also used in the vehicles also, as petrol and diesel. The combustion of the fossil fuel releases carbon dioxide to the air. So students, this is how carbon cycle takes place. So let us see now here the circulation and recycling of carbon from the atmosphere to the living organism and after their death back to the atmosphere is called carbon cycle. So this way you can define it. Abiotic carbon atoms are circulated and recycled into biotic form mainly through the photosynthesis and respiration. Hence, carbon cycle is one of the important biogeochemical cycle. So I hope you might have understood. Let me highlight the main point for you for this carbon cycle. I will highlight some points here that you have to study. So these are the main point what you have to study, that how the carbon cycle is here, and this diagram also it is very important, children. Now let us come to the chemical equation. Here two chemical equations are given here. Let me show you these chemical equations. First chemical equation is regarding photosynthesis. Here you can see 6CO2 plus 12H2O in presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, they form the C6H12O6, that is glucose, plus 6H2O plus 6O2. The arrow is upward, that means gas is going upward. And then next one is the respiration cycle. Here we can see glucose get oxidized, that means C6H12O6 plus 6O2. In mitochondria, the formation of 6CO2, that gas is going upward displacement, plus 6H2O plus energy. So eventually, after the death, all types of the consumer are decomposed by the decomposers that already I told you, and they release the carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, and further it is used by the living organism. So this way the carbon cycle is completed here, children. Hope you might have understood. And one more thing I want to let you know, children, that if you'll see the Institute of Ecology, then the Indian Institute of Ecology and Environment, Delhi, that was established in 1980, and it is involved in many research training as well as for arranging the workshop and seminar. This institute also published the International Encyclopedia of Ecology and the Environment. So I hope you might have understood this cycle here. Some more point if you want to see, you can see that carbon dioxide is released in the atmosphere through the abiotic process, like burning of fossil fuel, wood, forest fires and volcanic activity. Oxygen is released into the atmosphere by the biotic process of photosynthesis, and carbon dioxide through the respiration. The equilibrium of oxygen and carbon dioxide gases is present in the atmosphere, and that is maintained by the plant only. So here I stop my lecture, children. Hope you might have enjoyed the lecture. Thank you, children. See, this carbon cycle, it is very important, as well as the biogeochemical cycle is also important. You have to learn this both the cycle. Thank you.